I have John F. Kennedy's cigar box he used in the White House.
Wow, Pops, check this out.
This is John F. Kennedy's cigar box.
Sure is. And inside are the remaining unsmoked cigars.
Wow, really?
John F. Kennedy brought this cigar box to the White House, so it was in the Oval Office. I own the private museum, and I'm trying to raise money to get into a bigger facility. I'm asking $95,000, but I'm not sure how low I'll go. I'm just gonna kind of feel it out when I get in there.
So where did you get it?
Mrs. Lincoln, as personal secretary, befriended a man named Robert White, and she gave quite a few items to Robert White. So I made a private deal with the White estate to buy some of the items.
All right, his personal cigar box sold for over $500,000 to the guy who owns Cigar Aficionado magazine.
It did, but he didn't use that one. This is the one he actually used. This is the auction catalog, and there is a picture in here.
Okay. The box contains 11 hand-rolled cigars wrapped in clear plastic. What do we got there?
8. There's a few missing.
So someone smoked 3 of the cigars?
Not me. That's how I got it.
Perfecto Garcia Incense? Is that what it says on them?
Perfecto Garcia Incense, yes.
These are the ones that were left over. You know, if he would have lived, these would have been smoked.
JFK absolutely loved his cigars. And to actually have a cigar box that sat on his desk in the Oval Office is just one of those things I can only dream about. Do you have paperwork on this stuff?
Mm-hmm. It's documented by his personal secretary, Evelyn Lincoln.
All right.
She was there every day. And here you can see a description of the box.
This brown mahogany cigar box with a silver plaque was given to President John F. Kennedy by a friend on his birthday, May 29th, 1962. Okay. Do you have a receipt from White?
I don't have that with me.
The whole thing is, I hate it when, like, the chain of custody is broken, you know what I mean? This is one of those once-in-a-lifetime items. If I let this thing walk out the door, I'm never gonna see another one like it. How much are you asking?
Well, as you know, the other comparable one went for $500,000 or so. I need some quick cash, or else I would just put that in an auction and get 150, 200 grand, whatever it's gonna go for. I'll give it to you for 95,000.
I think the auction estimate was 100 and it didn't meet it. And you have some other documentation from the White collection that you bought all this stuff from.
I could get you a letter from Robert L. White's widow saying that I purchased the entire collection.
Okay. I'll give you 50 grand.
I can't do that.
That's cash right now.
70.
What do you think, son?
I wouldn't pay more than 50 grand, Pops. It's up to you.
I'll go 60.
All right, it's all on you. I'm out.
65 and you got a deal.
60 grand. I'll give you 30 now. Give me the rest of the paperwork. I'll give you the other 30.
Got it, man.
All right, meet you right over there and we'll do some paperwork.
Okay. I took 60. It's fine because if I would have put it in an auction, I would have had to wait about 6 months. We need money now to get this new facility, so I'm good.
Wow, this thing is nice.
This is a casting out.
This is like one of the holy grails of American coins.
I'll do 95 and that's it.
No, I don't think so. I think I'm gonna take it home.